You know that rheumatoid arthritis attacks the joints, but did you realize that this inflammatory disease can silently affect your eyes and vision? As a rheumatologist who treats this disease every single day, it is my duty to warn you about the eye complications that are linked to uncontrolled rheumatoid arthritis. I will also discuss how certain medications that we use to treat rheumatoid arthritis can potentially affect your vision. And I will teach you how to prevent and how to treat eye complications. So continue to watch because you will have a lot of things to learn. Let's begin.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
Hi, I'm Dr. Diana Girnita, a board-certified rheumatologist treating patients with rheumatoid arthritis every day. Let me tell you a story of one of my patients. One day, I was called to the hospital for a consultation, and this is how I met Evelyn, who was an 82-year-old lady who has been dealing with rheumatoid arthritis for more than 35 years. She came to the hospital because she had pain and severe changes in her eyes with changes in her vision, especially in her right eye more than the left. When I examined Evelyn, she had severe deformities in her hands and her feet as a result of rheumatoid arthritis. She told me that she was dealing with joint pain for about 30 years. However, she was afraid to start any treatment so far. She was using massive doses of aspirin to help her cope with the joint pain. When she mentioned that she started to have changes in her vision in the last 2 to 3 months, I looked into her eyes. And what did I see? Evelyn had very thin sclera, and this is the white part of the eyes, so thin that you could almost see through the back of her eyes. And I immediately consulted with an eye specialist. Unfortunately, the eye doctor confirmed my suspicion. Evelyn had developed a severe complications to her eyes because of uncontrolled and untreated rheumatoid arthritis for years. And she was now in danger to lose her eyesight. Now, what are the most common complications of eyes in patients with rheumatoid arthritis? The number one complication is dryness in the eyes. And this is very common, and most patients with rheumatoid arthritis will notice this sand-like sensation in the eyes. The more inflammation in the body, the worse of the dryness in the eyes. We call this sicca syndrome or secondary Sjogren syndrome. You may use eye drops to make you feel better, but until the systemic inflammation is controlled, that dryness will persist. The number two complication is inflammation of the eyes. We call this scleritis. Patients will describe redness, pain, and in more severe cases, changes in the vision. And this needs to be evaluated and treated by an eye doctor as soon as possible. Number three is scleromalacia. When inflammation continues, the white part of the eye can become so thin that the inside of the eye can be exposed, creating even more complications. And this was the case of my patient, Evelyn, who, because she did not treat the inflammation properly for more than 30 years, she was now close to losing her vision. But fortunately, the eye specialist was able to help her, and after she had the surgery, she was able to correct her vision. And then I convinced her that it is better to get proper treatment for rheumatoid arthritis and avoid taking massive doses of aspirin. There are also rare eye complications related to medication use. The most common medication incriminated for eye side effects is hydroxychloroquine or plaquenil. I actually have a video about plaquenil in my channel. Although the risk is small, I always discuss it with my patients and I ask them to have periodic eye exams to make sure their eyes stay healthy. The risk for eye disease, like changes in the way that you perceive color and retinal toxicity, is increasing with the dose that is used and also the time that the patient stay on this medication. So if the dose is high and you stay longer, then the risk is increased. However, studies show that if you stay on the recommended dose, the risk is about 3 to 4% after 10 years of use. But because I consider all my patients unique, I will also ask them to have eye exams every single year and send me the report to ensure that they are safe on hydroxychloroquine. How to prevent and treat eye complications? First, do not ignore the potential eye symptoms, because uncontrolled inflammation can permanently damage your delicate eye structures before you know it. Safeguarding your vision needs to be a top priority when you manage rheumatoid arthritis. But there is something that you can do about it besides medications only. I have an online course that you can take from anywhere in the world that will teach you all the pillars of the lifestyle changes that you need to make. This is all scientific-based evidence, including information about nutrition, exercise, mindfulness, and I even talk about supplements. Once again, this is all scientific-based. So check this out and deep dive into the nutrition and lifestyle changes that can be so beneficial to you. So you can improve your inflammation and you can reduce pain and avoid rheumatoid arthritis complications, but also live a better life even if you have rheumatoid arthritis. Treat rheumatoid arthritis early because that will stop the ongoing inflammation. Stay in contact with your rheumatologist and learn what are your options. You can also watch my other video about rheumatoid arthritis treatments and evaluate and discuss all these options with your rheumatologist. If you have rheumatoid arthritis and you are looking for a rheumatologist, or if you need to be evaluated for rheumatoid arthritis, my company, Rheumatologist on Call, might be of great help. If you are a resident in one of the US states that we serve, you can book a consultation and we are very happy to serve you. Our approach is very personalized, comprehensive, and we combine a holistic approach with traditional medicine. I hope this video was very helpful to you and will enhance your knowledge about rheumatoid arthritis. And if you have any comments, please don't forget to leave them in the section below. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to support my educational mission and to also learn about rheumatoid arthritis and many other autoimmune diseases. Until the next time, stay curious, stay strong, and get informed. Thank you.
Rheumatologistoncall.com